Good morning from Mission Control Houston, and welcome to today's International Space Station update. Joining us here inside of the flight control room, watching as the Orbit 2 team is sitting at console, monitoring all of their respective systems on board this orbiting laboratory. Today's team being led today by Flight Director Brian Smith. Joining him there at the Capcom position is Jeremy Hansen, serving as the communication link between all of our controllers down here on the ground and the astronauts up in space. Those astronauts right now, the crew of Expedition 34, kicking off their Monday with a lot of experiment and repair work on board the station. They're being led by NASA astronaut Kevin Ford there in the front row on the left. Behind him, Russian cosmonauts Oleg Novitskiy and Evgeny Tarelkin. Those three have been on board the International Space Station since late October. And then our three on the right, Russian cosmonaut Romanenko, Chris Hadfield from the Canadian Space Agency, and Tom Marshburn, another NASA astronaut all the way on the right there. The three later joining members of Expedition 34, they docked to the International Space Station back in late December. As mentioned, it's a pretty busy day for these astronauts up on orbit, starting with Commander Kevin Ford. He started his day off working on the station's waste and hygiene compartment, also known as the toilet on board the station. He's doing some routine replacement work on the urine receptacle and also its insert filter, so he'll be removing those and replacing them. And then a little bit later today, he'll be working on the high-rate communications system. He'll be removing a few of the remnants of the older medium-rate communications outage recorder, installing a new closeout panel over that and a new interface panel as they prepare to do some more work a little bit later in this increment on that high-rate comm system and doing a few more upgrades. Moving on, Russian cosmonaut Oleg Novitskiy is inside of the Russian service module doing some repair work that's been going on over the past month or so on the interior panels inside of there. He'll also be doing some Earth observations for the Russian Sinar investigation. It's an ongoing look at the various world oceans and searching for bioproductive water areas, both for commercial fishing and also scientific research. Aside from that, he'll be doing a Russian life on board the International Space Station, doing some photo and video for that. He'll be joined in that by his two fellow Russian cosmonauts. The three have been doing that. It's an ongoing look at life on board the station from the Russian side. And, again, assisting him in that, Evgeny Tarelkin, another one of our Russian cosmonauts on board the station. Evgeny will also be assisting Novitskiy with those repairs of those interior panels inside of the service module. Also, he'll be doing a study of the cardiovascular system today using one of the exercise bikes on board the station over in the Russian segment known as the Velo. So he'll be exercising and then measuring his heart's capacity and how it responds to the loads. It's one of the many ongoing experiments looking at the human body as it's exposed to microgravity for long periods of time. Moving on, our third Russian cosmonaut, Romanenko, doing a lot of house cleaning work today, replacing a few of the dust filters and the collectors inside of the Russian segment, and also clearing out some of the air ducts and the fan screens, as they consistently have to keep this air revitalization system clean to ensure a safe breathing environment for all of their crew members. He'll also be doing a Russian Earth observation experiment known as the Urogan, which is done by recording various catastrophic phenomena as they develop in the hopes of creating the International Space Station and making it into a permanent monitoring where any monitoring posts where any natural and man-made disasters are forecasted. Then our Canadian Space Agency astronaut Chris Hadfield today working on two pretty interesting experiments, the first of which, the binary colloidal alloy test, C1. He'll be initializing that and taking some photography of some of the samples. That's a look at studying nanoscale particles that are dispersed in liquid known as colloidal suspension. These colloids are commonly found in a lot of commercial commodities down here on Earth, such as paint, electronic polishing compounds, and also food products. He'll also be working with the InSpace 3 experiment. It's a look at the fundamental behavior of different magnetic colloidal fluids as they're influenced by varying magnetic fields. These materials are used in a lot of vibration dampening systems and very large-scale projects like bridges and buildings down here on Earth. So a microscopic experiment up on the station having some pretty wide-reaching implications back down here on the surface. And our final Expedition 34 crew member Tom Marshburn, another NASA astronaut working inside of the cell biology experiment facility in the Japanese experiment module. He's installing a new centrifuge inside of that. It's a that cell biology experiment facility. It's a Japanese Aerospace Agency sub-rack used for studying various life science experiments such as cultivating cells and also growing plants inside of the Japanese experiment module. Here you can see some video a little bit earlier today as Marshburn was working on that. And some of his other duties for the day include work inside of the water recovery system, filling up a few of the contingency water containers, and doing a few minor repairs.